And when the mob is coming, you know, it's our fate. It's like that. And they directly put their snake, and as a garland, means that some chain there, they
wrap the
snake. Yeah, yeah, wrap the snake on his neck.
What's up, guys? Welcome to the video. So today we have my father, Dr. Jaitilal. He is currently working as the HOD biochemistry department. And so, you know, I had asked my father about his opinion about the current situation and what he had to say. So he had a lot of interesting points, given the fact that he did work as a government sector. I mean, he did work in the government sector, in the rural sector, and he has faced such situations. He didn't have the emotion that I had portrayed. You know, I had a feeling of fear. I had a feeling of frustration seeing this whole social media thing about the doctors, but then he was unfazed by it. And that actually came from an area of experience. So that is why we are having this conversation, so that he could give us, you know, he could give me, and also he could give you guys an insight to about what exactly we can do to mitigate such a situation. Okay, so the first question that I have is, what is your general opinion about the attacks that have been seen on doctors?
In my opinion, this kind of happenings were always there in this profession, because our profession, we are directly interacting with the patients and we are dealing with the pains and tragedies of the patients. So we cannot predict how the people will react in such situations. For example, I was in government sector for 2 to 3 years, and I actually resigned from government sector because of this kind of attitude of the people. And after resigning from the government sector, I joined in medical education. In government hospitals, especially Kerala Health Service, in the health service sector, these things are very common, because the common people, when they are coming as a mob, they are not educated. They are reacting unpredictably for even trivial incidents. What I am saying is that you should be very careful. As far as you have already selected this profession, it is your responsibility to handle the profession in an ideal way. For example, for a driver, a good driver is always, he will always anticipate an accident throughout his journey. That means he will always be in vigilance. This kind of things will happen, and it's a totally unfortunate, very much unfortunate. People should not react like this. So it cannot be justified. At any point of time, it cannot be justified.
So the next question that I had was, how does this take place? Like, what is the progression? Because in social media, what we often see is just the highlights, you know, just the extremes. For example, we saw the beating of the doctors. Now, that is the extreme. But so in your experience, what is it that actually starts? What are the things that we should look out for in such an event?
You know, comparing our medical profession with other professions, our profession, the things are happening in an unpredictable way. We don't know a patient will become bad. So we cannot predict. As far as with the best of our ability and knowledge, even if we are treating the patient may go for a bad situation. It's unpredictable. But the thing is that how we are handling that situation is very important. We may not be able to handle the death of a patient, but we can handle the emotions generated from the death of the patient, in his or her relatives. Only thing is that we have to convince the patient's relatives about the disease of the patient, or the condition, or the situation of the patient. Suppose a patient, especially these kind of happenings are occurring in emergency situation. For example, a snake bite, or a hang, or a drowning, or a lightning, or a burn injury, or road traffic accident. In all such situations, when the patient is brought to the hospital, he will be brought to the hospital with a lot of people. You know, suppose somebody is happened to know A or B or X or Y person is had such a lightning injury, all the people in that area will accompany him
towards the hospital.
And most of the time, these people may not be knowing even this patient, actually what happened to the patient, what is his condition. They will be totally ignorant about the situation. But the thing is that when they are coming together as a mob, their psychology will be entirely different. They will never respond to the situation, but they will emotionally react with the situation. Probably they may be coming, the important persons, some political leaders or religious leaders, they will be coming with the patients. At that time, their motive is not the safety of the injured patient. Their motive is not at all the safety or security of the patient. They want to show off their local importance among to the public. So they will overshy, they will overreact, as if they will make the patients or relatives believe that they are the leaders. They will handle the situation, even though they are not having any relation with the patient. So such a barbarian people are making the problem everywhere. Most of 95% of the time, patient or patient relatives are convinced, even if we are convincing them, these people will make problems. This is happening everywhere throughout the country. I had a personal experience. Once a patient was, while I was working as a casualty medical officer in Palakkad District Hospital, I started my government profession from Palakkad District Hospital. At that time, a patient was brought with a road traffic accident, a young boy, but he was accompanied with hundreds of local people. They just came into the casualty department. It's not a vast place. It's a very constricted place there in those days, constrained area. So this much of people are rushing into the hospital with this accident boy. They are behaving to the doctors very rude.
As if they own the place.
Yes. So suddenly we just managed the case. A wound was there, a bleeding wound, but there was multiple injury, bone fractures were there, and that bleeding wound was stitched and the bleeding was stopped. I suddenly started an IV drip, and I just convinced the boy's father and mother about the situation he is facing. I told them that orthopedic doctor was on leave on that day, so orthopedician was not available in the hospital, so we cannot do anything.
That's a situation.
Yeah. So just I wrote a referring letter, but the parents of the boy was convinced, they were ready. I told them, please take him to Thrissur Medical College. At that time, very important institution. It is 20 years back, I am speaking, 20 to 25 years back. And they took the boy in a vehicle to the Thrissur Medical College. But after that, so many people came there. They want to know about the real condition. Why you are referring? Why can't you do it here? Why can't you manage the case there? And when I was saying orthopedician is not, why orthopedician is not available?
Their emotions are actually
available. Yeah. So this kind of thing. At that time, we should be very humble. We should be very humble and convincing. See, if we are reacting in the same way, what will happen? They will beat me. Who am I? I am just after completing my house surgery. I just joined in the health service. What knowledge I have? Can I do orthopedic surgery? Can I reduce a fracture? See, the same people will use the same language in another way. If any complication happens, if I am managing it from there, they will ask me, why you are managing here? Why can't you send the patient? That is the situation. Actually, the mob is just like a barbarian, and they are just like, they are
highly inflammable
and explosive.
So even a small spark of emotion that we show,
yeah,
they'll multiply it. Use that and
and because they are politicians, so they want to show off their importance to their accompanying locals. That's why they are behaving like that. But what I'm saying is, when you are working in an emergency department, always anticipate such incidents. In Malayalam, there's a saying, vadiyil paambundaavu kayil chootu karudanam. It's a saying in Malayalam. Vadiyil paambundaavu means definitely there will be snake on the way. So keep a torch. Like that, we doctors have to, especially those who are working in emergency departments, we should always anticipate any kind of such casualties may happen at any time, unpredictably. So we should be prepared to face that. First, we have to convince the patient and the bystanders. And when the mob is coming, it's our fate. It's like that. Actually, this should be handled by the law and order system of the government. It's the responsibility of the government people and the police department to amicably solve the problem. One thing, once I had another experience, a boy was brought with a snake bite. And he was having some, they brought him very late. And he was almost, it's a wiper. There was no such emergency that the hospital was not well developed in those days.
To manage.
Yeah. So, no specialists were available. So, naturally, after giving the basic things, that boy was kept in the hospital. And we called the parents of the patient. They were really convinced. Fortunately, we got anti-snake venom. And we gave. The boy was okay. No problem. There was no systemic complications. But after some time, a mob came with a snake. They killed the snake. They killed that snake and they brought that snake. And they directly coming and asking, who is looking after the boy? Who is treating the boy? The physician in charge was there. And they directly put that snake and as a garland, means that some chain there.
Wrap the snake
on his neck. Is this the correct way to handle a situation? What actually the doctor did? What he did? The boy is almost cured.
Situation is there. Control.
But these people want to show off.
They want to show off.
This kind of incidents are very... See, it is the responsibility of the government and the law and order system to solve such... In each hospital, there should be a police control room attached with the emergency department. Then only this can be managed. Because mob means we cannot do anything. 100 or 200 people are coming together as wildfire. What we can do?
I think the best thing that we can do is just to be grounded, be firm with what we believe and not talk back. You know, we should not provoke the mob in any way.
That is very important.
We should just be passive and kind of listen to them, you know. Because if we say something back, like... Because, of course, we are the ones who are in charge, ideally. But if we think that we are in charge and if we do something that is against the mob, then that would trigger their reaction. And that's when they attack, you know, that's when they go all in and attack the doctor and attack everything. You know, as on an individual level, I think the best thing that we can do is learn how to communicate with them properly and learn how to handle the situation. Because naturally, our first response, because we have done everything we can, and naturally, our first response is if they say one, we'll say two. And you know, our response is to fight against them, at least verbally to fight against them. And that is what usually leads, that is what usually ignites them, and that is what usually triggers them. And that's when things go out of hand.
That's correct. See, I have seen some posts from young doctors in social media. One of the young doctors was saying that instead of handling that, when we are being beaten, we have to beat the people back. And handle the violence should be answered with the violence. See, that is horrible. The thing, you know, how can private institutions, private hospitals can exist? See, if the doctor is beating back the patient's bystanders or if he is attacked by the mob and if these doctors together, they are fighting back, can the hospital exist next day? So they have to be there. Tomorrow also we have to work. So violence is not at all the answer for violence. So we have to handle it amicably. We have to convince the patient, convince the bystanders, convince the people who are accompanying the patient in a very humble and simple way. Only thing is that the most important thing is that what all treatment we are giving to the patient, we have to convince the patients, bystanders. What all investigations we are going to do, we have to convince them. Why we are doing such investigations, we have to convince them. Whatever medications or surgical procedures we are going to do on the patient, we have to convince them. So each and every activities that we are doing on the patients, if it is properly communicated, these people will become content. But if we are not communicating anything, if we are not speaking to them, if we are not detailing or describing the situation to them, they'll become violent.
Yes.
So we have to convince the people what I am doing, why I am doing, why I am referring, why I am keeping the patient in the hospital, what are the possibilities I can do, what all things I cannot do, what all assistance I need from my colleagues. So everything, if it is properly explained to the patient in time, to his relatives, we can this kind of complex, it may not go chances, as a complicate.
The chances of it going, we can reduce it.
Yeah, we can reduce this. Of course, you young doctors, you're all working in a hospital. Young doctors are working force. Young doctors are the working force of the hospital. They may not have proper sleep. They may not be taking food normally. Means they won't get tired. They may be very much worried. At the same time, young people are very egoistic. They are lack of life experiences. So we should never react emotionally with such situations. See, why? If we should never react with our violence.
Yes.
Because if we are doing this, the mob is having political power. So they will do anything. Even they will even kill you.
The attacks that we have seen, if that can be done, if we retaliate.
Next day, if 100 people are coming today, the next day 1,000 people will come. They will even smash down the hospital. So always try to solve the issues in a peaceful, amicable way rather than through violence. So the thing is that, as I said, a good driver is a driver who is always anticipating a danger on the road. Always anticipating the danger on the road. So he will be driving the vehicle with vigilance. Anything can happen at any time. As far as you have already chosen this profession, you have to accept the realities of this profession. You have to accept the psychology of the people, the psychology of the mob, the power of politics, the power of religion. There is no justice. Justice is nowhere. So it's the responsibility of the government to make the situations calm. The government should not allow the violence of the mob. The doctor's profession is a very... See, we are dealing with the life of people. So no such profession is noble as this profession. At the same time, the doctor should have also that feeling. What I'm doing is a very noble thing. So I should be that much value-based attitude towards my profession, towards my patient, towards his relatives, towards the society, like that. That's what my personal opinion related with this issue.